Onions and testosterone. Do onions really boost testosterone? It's a claim that you hear time and time again on TikTok, but how true really is that? In this video, we will look at all of the possible ways that onions could boost testosterone, and also three things that you want to consider before trying out onions. And if you already eat onions regularly, here's just more information on them. And what may surprise you is that they aren't suited for everyone. And it's important that you know both the pros and cons without any of the fluff. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. Onions, otherwise known as allium sepa, are one of the most popular root vegetables and are loaded with a ton of vitamins and minerals, which you can take a look at here, as well as all of its macros, and an interesting compound, which I'll come to in a bit. In fact, according to the National Onion Association, per capita onion consumption has risen over 70% in the last two decades, from 12.2 pounds per person in 1982 to just over 20 pounds per person in 2018. And don't be surprised if that number continues thanks to all the new TikTok trends. And don't get me wrong, onions can be a great addition to your diet. And personally, I like them because of two major reasons. One, they got great sulfur-containing compounds, and two, they got antioxidants, a big one known as quercetin. And quercetin has been studied time and time again for lowering inflammation, lowering blood pressure, and supporting blood sugar control. But for testosterone, it's an excellent question to be asking, and there isn't a lot of human studies as I would like, because a lot of the studies have been done on male rats, with the exception of one done on healthy men. But let me break down the three roadmaps as to why it has been postulated and frequented so much on social media, and where I think the research will go in the future. And then afterwards, I'll tell you about the three reasons why you should think twice about onions, which many others have glossed over, so that we get a full picture, which this channel is all about. Starting with the first one, onions' effects on LH, or what's known as luteinizing hormone. You see, testosterone is mainly synthesized in Leydig cells in males and the ovaries and adrenal glands in females. And when we look at the Leydig cell, the amounts of the produced testosterone in this cell is under the control of LH. And the formed testosterone in the Leydig cells is then transported to Sertoli cells in the testes to enhance sperm production. So if LH is responsible for the amount of testosterone, how do onions play a role? Well, it turns out in the animal study, onions have a positive impact on production of luteinizing hormone, and the positive effect of onion on testosterone is attributed back to the increased level of LH. So that's the first roadmap: onions increasing LH, increasing Leydig cell production of testosterone. Let's take a look at the second one. And this is where it gets interesting. Onions' effects on nitric oxide. It is well documented that a decrease in blood flow to the testes reduces the synthesis of testosterone. So to work around that, how do we increase the blood flow, especially with onions? Well, it turns out onions positively affect nitric oxide, which is a free radical gas that is produced by nitric oxide synthase. What it does is it acts as a vasodilator, opening up the blood vessels, increasing blood flow to the testes, and promotes synthesis of testosterone. And not to forget to mention the critical role nitric oxide has for blood vessels around the body in general. Take a look at this visual here. The more nitric oxide you have, the easier your blood is to flow through. But over time, as inflammation and arterial plaque builds up, the less nitric oxide can help ease the way for your blood to flow through. And lastly, the effects of onions on 5-AMP activated protein kinase. And think of this as your cell's master switch. It plays a ton of roles in the body, from fatty acid oxidation to helping make sure your sugar in the blood is stored correctly, all the way to producing testosterone in the testes. And what makes onions so unique is its high amounts of quercetin. And quercetin is what's activating the important protein kinase. Although more research is needed on this to come to a more thorough conclusion, since a lot of the observation has been in animal models, what we do know is that quercetin is studied for its uses in supporting the heart, circulation, prostate health, and exercise recovery. And if you're wondering which onion has the most quercetin, it's gonna be the chartreuse onion, which has a more yellowish glow than your typical yellow onion. So now that we got the three main ways onions have been touted for boosting testosterone, I'm gonna leave you with three reasons why you probably should skip onions. The first is if you have IBS or irritable bowel syndrome. This is because onions are what's considered a FODMAP because they are a fructan, which is a type of oligosaccharide, which stands for the O in FODMAP. That can make your symptoms of IBS worse, anywhere from abdominal pain, cramping, or bloating. So here's a trick to work around that. Green onion. You've seen them before. The tops are lower in FODMAPs than the bottoms. So use the tops of them instead if you can't give them up, because onions are too good to give up completely, am I right? The second is, it can make your heartburn worse if you suffer from heartburns. Not everyone has trouble with it, but if you cut out fried foods, spicy foods, and citrusy foods and still have heartburn, consider if onions could be the culprit. Since not a lot of people know this, but the fermentable fiber in the onion called fructooligosaccharides, they can actually relax the lower esophageal sphincter. And when that is relaxed, acid has an easier time to come make its way back up and increase the reflux. And lastly, this may not impact you directly, but if you are a pet owner of a cat, dog, horse, or even a monkey, keep your pets away from onions. The sulfoxides in the onions can cause the Heinz body anemia disease, which affects your pet's red blood cells. And remember, just because a food may be healthy for a human, they aren't always healthy for your pet. In the meantime though, if you don't struggle from eating onions, there's no reason to stop eating them. And if you're looking on more ways to increase testosterone from your diet, then check out the video I made on pomegranates on the left right here. I would love to hear your thoughts down below. And in the meantime, click the red subscribe button down below if you found any value, and I'll see you on the next one.